Windows as an operating system comes with a large number of pre-installed programs that most users do not need, and at the same time significantly slow down the performance of the computer. If you want to speed up your operating system by removing unnecessary programs and at the same time installing those that you do need, here is the simple way to do it. Chris Titus Tech Windows Utility is a program that serves as a collection of scripts designed to simplify installations, remove or disable background programs, adjust Windows to your needs, troubleshoot configuration issues, and manage Windows update settings. When you visit the GitHub page for this application, where you can also see the code since it is an open source program, all you need to do to run it is to copy the command that you will also find in the video description, run PowerShell as an administrator, paste the copied command, and then press Enter. The program does not install, instead it downloads a script from a GitHub and runs it on your computer by the command line. Therefore, you will not find any installation files or icons for the program on your computer. Consequently, each time you want to run this program, you will need to do it in this manner, in other words, by entering the command in PowerShell. PowerShell remains open while the program is running, allowing you to monitor all processes that are taking place. Once the program starts, you will first see the programs you can install or remove from your computer, grouped into 9 categories. When you click the plus icon next to the group name, you will see all the programs within the group, each of which you can install or update by clicking the arrow icon or remove by clicking the trash can icon. The list of applications you can install this way is quite extensive, and you can go through all of the options. However, if you want to see all programs in a list format, you can do so by clicking the slider in the compact view box, after which a list of all programs will be displayed. To install the desired programs, all you need to do is check them. For example, I will select Firefox, Visual Studio Code, and LibreOffice. When you click Install Upgrade Selected button, the programs you have checked will be installed, and if you are already having them, the application will update them to the latest version. Upon the first launch of this application, it will first execute updates for the Windows application necessary for the application to function properly, primarily Winget, which is used for installations. If you have an out-of-date version, wait for the update to complete, and as you will see, you will need to restart the program. Once you do that, you will receive a notification that Winget has been updated, and you can now proceed with installing applications. The speed of installation, of course, depends on the number of the applications you have selected, but you can monitor the entire process in the PowerShell window, which gives you a clear insight into which phase of the installation process is in. When the installation successfully completes, you will receive a message saying installs have finished, and when you return to the Windows menu and check, you will see that the applications you selected are now installed. In addition to installing new applications, the program offers the ability to detect all applications on the list that are already installed on your computer. You can do this by clicking Get Installed button. Once you receive a list, you can update all applications by clicking the Update All button, or you can update only some by unchecking those you do not want and leaving only the ones you wish to update, then clicking Install Upgrade Selected button. In the same manner, you can uninstall a selected application by clicking Uninstall Selected. When discussing the programs and settings that come by default with Windows, we can customize them by clicking the Tweaks button. Here we can see all the options that program offers, grouped into three categories: Essential Tweaks, Advanced Tweaks, and Customized Preferences. If you are unsure or unfamiliar with what certain settings do, there are two recommended settings, Standard and Minimal. If you click on Standard, the program will check the options that fall under that category, and you can go through all of them and decide whether you want to deselect any or add options that are not checked. For example, Disable Recall is not checked, and if you click on question mark next to this option, you will be automatically redirected to a website where you will receive a brief description of this function, in other words, its purpose, as well as the script code that will be executed if you activate this option. Recall is currently not active by default in Windows, which is why this option is not checked. However, if Microsoft decides to reactivate this feature after many user complaints and the security risk it poses, this is a simple and effective way to disable that application. It is advisable to always check the Restore Point option when you're making changes, so you have the ability to recover everything to its original state if you decide to do so for any reason. As you can see, there are also advanced settings available, such as removing unnecessary applications related to Adobe packages, disabling Microsoft Copilot application. You can disable the use of all ports, which can pose a significant security risk. If you recently transitioned to Windows 11 and you are not a fan of the new right-click menu design, you can restore the classic right-click menu from Windows 10, which looks like this. You can do this by checking the Set Classic Right-Click Menu option, which I will select in this case. You can remove the OneDrive application, which is currently active on my PC, as you can see. Since I don't use it, I will check this option as well. You also have the option to remove Microsoft Edge, which is Windows' default web browser, and many users wish to do this, but I would not recommend it, as it can lead to many issues since Edge is integrated into Windows 11. It is very difficult to predict all consequences, as there is a high likelihood that some other applications you use may not function properly after removing Edge web browser. We can clearly see the results of these adjustments by opening the Task Manager before we apply them and checking the number of processes running in Windows. Currently, as you can see, we have 140 processes running in background, and after we apply all of the settings and restart the computer, we will reopen the Task Manager to see what data we get then. The third segment is Customized Preferences. Here you can adjust some options that do not affect the operating system itself, but can help tailor Windows to your preferences. For example, you can disable or enable dark mode, disable Bing search in start menu, and make similar adjustments. To apply all the settings, we will click the Run Tweaks button, after which we will be able to monitor all the processes occurring in the PowerShell terminal. This process may take some time, especially if it is an old computer that has not had its operating system change for a long period. As you may notice, the icon of the OneDrive application, which was previously in the lower right corner, has now disappeared because the application has been completely removed. Once the process is complete, we will also check to see if we successfully returned the classic right-click menu from Windows 10. Within this menu, the program also offers the option to run Shut Up 10++, which we have covered in one of our previous videos. If you haven't seen it yet and wish to do so, be sure to check the link in the video description for more information. When we click on Config button, the program will allow you to install certain programs and activate features that are not enabled by default. For example, you can enable Windows Sandbox, Hyper-V virtualization, or activate F8 boot recovery, which is a very practical option that was characteristic for Windows 7. You can also perform multiple repairs, such as resetting Windows Update, resetting the network, scanning system for errors, reinstalling WinGet, and so on. When you click on Updates, you have three options related to updating Windows itself. The first option is Default Settings. If you select this option, Windows will update as soon as updates become available. And this is Default Setting. The second option is Recommended, Security Settings, which, as described, will delay application updates within Windows for 2 years, but security parts of the updates will be applied 4 days after release. The third option is to disable all updates. If you select this option, Windows will no longer receive updates, and this option, as you can see, is not recommended, but of course, if that is what you want, you can apply it to your operating system. The final option, MicroWin, allows you to customize Windows to your needs before installation by uploading the Windows ISO file and then making the adjustments you want according to instruction found in this segment. Finally, we will restart the computer to see the state in the task manager. As you can see, from the previous 140 processes, after these few simple steps, we have significantly reduced the number of processes running in the background. Thanks to everyone who took the time to watch this video. I hope you find it useful or at least informative.